2. Oh my goodness.
Welcome back!
Oh!
Oh dear god.
Hey! How's it going?
Hey!
Hey, we beat your map, by the way.
Oh, yeah.
Corona Caves. Corona Trails.
Get your name right.
I think it's Myraid Trails.
Myraid Trails.
Myraid Trails, yeah.
That's what it is.
Wait, I need to get in on the... Oops. Thingy-majig.
What thingy-majig is that? Oh, yeah. Yeah. We got these in the Corona Citadel. I thought maybe we should wear them. So, I don't know if you've ever seen this map render. It's pretty good.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. It's pretty good. I mean, probably one of the best maps in history.
Scale from 1 to 10, it's definitely at least a 1.5.
Yeah. At least.
That sounds good.
Yeah. So, yeah. We figured we would just do a little playthrough of the map in creative mode. Not really a playthrough. More of a walkthrough. I just kind of talk about stuff, if we had anything to talk about.
Oh my god, there's a secret thing here.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, I was about to ask, did you guys actually see this? There are a few secrets that you just missed in the first area.
Cole. Oh.
Yeah, just
Whoops. Go on. what is it?
There's nothing there anymore.
It's a fishing rod with lure 3 and mending.
Ah.
I mean, okay.
That was nice.
Yeah.
I guess.
I don't know that is something we would have even used. I really don't know. Yeah. I don't think so, but... Huh.
Yeah, so how did you guys like this area, like for a starting area?
It's beautiful.
It is definitely beautiful. Like, this entire creation was just so beautifully made.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. When you start off in the... Is that... Seriously? Is toggle downfall is not... How do you start the...
Toggle downfall. Yeah.
Okay. Is it all one word?
Yeah.
That would explain it. This is really something to take in when you start off.
Oh yeah, so, and it's all it was, snowy.
It was really nice.
Yeah, so, it snowed for like one day. So it's day, just morning. And then when it's night, I was hoping people would go either in. To the cave or inside the dungeon, and then it would come out and it's all clear again because it's just morning, and then
they
would finally see the area fully.
Yeah,
how long did it take us?
A couple of days.
Yeah,
we hid in the that building up there for a day.
yeah,
you will never get full effect. So,
yeah, most people that I've watched have been around in this area long enough to see it turn to day.
Mm-hmm.
So. Yeah, it's a thing that happens.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah,
so...
Definitely very impressive.
Yeah.
So, with this map, I want a linear map, but I like open world in general. So, I had mainly intersections, but I had a lot of branching areas. And just this first area was kind of an example of how the map is going to play. Like, this is... like an open world area, and you can go either to the tower, you can either go to the tree, you can go to whatever.
Right.
Oh. Kind of to give you a feel.
I don't think it really sunk into us that it was kind of an open world in some aspects until we got a few dungeons in.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you could kind of see the way that everything connected with the tunnels, and then there were, you know... various dungeons branching off of other dungeons, so I mean, but the connections, I think once we finally started getting the connections, then it sunk in, you know.
Yeah, and the first little dungeon area was a nice little small dungeon to get to the wool.
Yeah,
and I think we averaged one or two deaths here.
Yeah, Kit died 2 times. Oh, hey, you died 4 times. Hey!
yeah, spoiler for you, sorry.
I don't care.
Yeah.
Oh, you'll see them. They're glorious.
Yeah.
I think I killed him just as many times as you did, so...
That's, yeah.
Just backstabbed him 4 times.
Basically, yeah.
Well, no, backstab means intent. And I wasn't smart enough to intend to kill him.
T- totally worth it.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So what things did you guys miss here? You got the thing under here, right? Did
you? The what? Where are you?
No, you didn't. Over here?
There was something under there.
Yeah, okay. It was an X, and it was an X, and I was like, oh, it should be something under here.
Huh.
But yeah. Was just something to kickstart your small farm.
I think I don't even remember if I punched out some of this ice thinking there'd be something under there and then gave up real quick.
You did.
Yeah.
Yeah, you did. You punched out some of it.
I did.
Yeah. A lot of people did. A lot of people actually just almost got it and then just stopped.
That's funny.
That was
wow.
So sad. Yeah. And another secret you missed. If you guys look at the sky and all these
snowflakes.
Yeah.
There's a big one. If you guys noticed it. Yeah. And
wow.
Oh, no. The resource pack isn't on. Oh, it has a custom texture and all. It's really amazing.
Oh, it is.
It's like a blaze rod sword.
Oh.
It's really cool.
Okay. I don't know why the resource pack isn't on. I guess.
Yeah, with servers, it's annoying to install.
Oh, yeah, I didn't know that we should have done that.
Yeah.
Is there a note about that in the readme?
Nope. Should probably do that.
There you go. Look at us! We're beta testers! pretty simple starting area, though.
Yeah. Simple,
so,
nice,
it was, it was nice and relaxing. I don't want to go through there. I'm going to go through the shortcut.
Yeah, oh. if you actually missed the star thing, you can actually... get another chance to find it.
Well, we missed it twice then.
it was that riddle in I2 with in the primeval woods. Is it primeval? Is it primeval or is it primeval?
It's primeval.
Okay.
Primal.
Yeah. It's primeval. Don't
primal.
Mess with the guy. It's definitely primeval.
I've always
yeah.
learned it's primal. So every time you say primeval, I'm like, you're saying it wrong, but oh well, I don't want to correct you.
No, I think it's prime and fall, as in valley maybe, so whatever.
Of course, I'm barely literate, so I don't think you should.
Sword.
You should probably listen to the English major.
Yeah.
Game mode one.
When we got to intersection one, we actually went everywhere except for the... monument first, and the thing I've noticed is we're also not the only ones to have done that.
Yeah, that was intentional actually. Yeah. I wanted I hoped some people would find it via Aurora Valley, as there's a connection between them, and somebody actually did.
Was it
Largon?
Was it him? Okay.
Yeah,
sounds about right.
And I think it gives them more of a surprise.
Yeah.
And it also kind of teaches you to actually look actually in the areas, scout ahead instead of just choosing one. But
yeah, the exploration in this one was a lot more than I think I've experienced in any of your maps. There's just every corner had something in it.
Yeah. Okay. Cool. Goliath was basically the same, but just way bigger and emptier.
Well, and it's possible that I missed a lot in Goliath because I was still pretty much a noob. So
you did.
That was the second CTM I ever played.
Oh,
so I
God.
I missed a ton.
Bless your soul.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
So we went to Chill Blast Mines first, I think.
Did we?
I think so.
Probably. No, you guys went to Aurora, but it doesn't care.
Oh.
I don't really recall. Oh, yeah, we totally did. I think we didn't have to come back to these places too often to get stuff. This one we came back to just because there's a lot of loot in here.
Oh, yeah, this... I want the player to have, like the noobish players, because this map is... somebody asked me to make something for Realms. So I made this for people for Realms that have, like, literally no experience. So if they die, and if they die 20 times, they wouldn't just be frustrated and have no stuff. Oh, by the way.
Okay. The one block out of place. Ah, you gotta be kidding. Potions. Okay. Man, oh man. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you show him. You show him, Kit. You show him, Kit.
No, no.
Yeah, this place supplied us for a good portion of the game, of the early game.
Oh yeah.
Because, I mean, there was just, and then this room here with all the goodies. Yeah. So.
Oh yeah.
There was a lot in here.
Oh yeah.
I came back here a couple of times.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, me too.
How many records did you guys get?
10, I think. We can look when we get to the mine.
Oh,
when we have
we missed two.
Yeah.
Yeah, you missed two. There's one here.
Oh, my goodness.
And you can actually see it from over here as well.
Oh, my goodness. Seriously?
Like, yeah, if you... So it's like this.
Oh, wow.
I thought it was really obvious, but so many people actually missed this.
I've never seen a single person find it yet from out here, at least.
I would never have gotten it unless you...
Maybe I should do something like this. That would be more obvious, I guess. But...
I don't know, man. When I'm down here, I'm not focusing up there. So
you're focusing on all the death.
I saw some people. I think it was Lorgan as well, maybe LNG, just looking straight at this, and I was like, "Come on, look at it! Notice it, goddammit!"
I haven't watched LNG yet because I think he did the whole map in like two episodes.
Yeah.
So I figured I would just watch his all at once. So. I imagine it's traditional LNG blazing through the place, you know, kicking butt and taking names. But this place, for new players, this place is a godsend. There's so much wood that, like, you don't need to farm trees ever.
Oh, yeah, same for Aurora.
Yeah, that too. But this place is flat, so... It immediately, right there, makes it so much easier than Aurora Valley.
Most areas in this map are actually really flat, because it actually, I think it, most people like it more, because it gives way more maneuverability and just dodging shit.
Oh, absolutely.
So it makes it way more fun.
The horrible terrain, like the stuff you got in...
Myriad, yeah.
Yeah, that...
That's
exhausting.
It's a different challenge.
What?
Oh wait.
Yeah, we missed this one.
Yeah.
But it's.
Oh, you got the other one.
Did we?
Well, that had a creeper spawn, I think.
We played a lot of this lower mine area in a bit of a panic.
It
was very hectic, so we didn't really look as we were here, and then when we came back later, we came back for very specific things, so we probably missed quite a bit around these parts.
Yeah. Did you ever...
We never farmed up these guys. We never farmed up any of the custom mobs, actually.
Wasn't really needed, but like the coal golems and the just all the material golems in general are basically just your infinite amount of resources if you really need them.
Right, and we didn't. I mean, we could have, and we kind of thought about it at times, but...
I mean,
use of what we had, so...
I mean, I literally threw so many resources at you.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, there's so much resources.
And I think that's also a bit fun for new players.
It is. I mean, we were, toward the end, I think we were bordering on Inferno Mine-style loot fatigue... Where you just have so much stuff, you don't know what to do. But at the end, we were also swimming in goodness, and we could just kind of say, well, at the moment, we need this, and we just take that and move on with our lives, you know?
Yeah.
So it wasn't that bad, and we didn't feel any obligation to truck everything out, because we knew we were reaching the end, and so it's like, all right, we're good. Let's just go.
Yeah. But the loot got quite heavy.
Yeah, but also keep in mind, you know, it's nice, like, especially in a void level like the last dungeon is, if you fall off of that more than a few times, than a few inventory wipes, I would appreciate having more loot.
Oh, hey, we completely missed that.
Okay.
That is, when did I play this?
Resources,
shit. It's a really old chest, I think.
It's new to us.
It's
brand new. You just put it there right now.
I guess since we're heading down here.
Yeah.
This was cool.
So, why did you choose to do a spider?
I got a filter from Envy and Bitemar. Just search that via Twitter. and he had like this underworld filter which made these gigantic webs. And I thought I could use that in like a vertical area like this. I think it looks quite nice.
I was thinking,
well, if you have giant webs, what do you need then? Giant spider.
Giant spider.
Yeah.
Wow, it is deadly down here.
Oh, I'm glad
I never fell down here.
I'm surprised I lived when I fell down here.
Yeah, I was like, wait, what? What is happening to him?
How did I not instantly die? There are so many spawners.
Where did you get out?
There was water.
Yeah.
It was like right
over here.
Oh, yeah. Because one of us decided to bring a water bucket pretty much everywhere.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I'm glad I did that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. This was the first dungeon, I think, that we felt threatened.
Yeah, everything else we were kind of like, oh, this is easy. This one we were like, wow. we actually need to focus.
It was kind of the intention of this one as well. To be actually more of a challenge compared to the rest.
And then...
The stuff down here actually was lava at first.
Oh god, that's mean.
But yeah, I changed it to this because of the fire theme of the map.
Well, yeah. I'm glad you didn't do lava, because that means that I was able to get some of my stuff back.
Right.
That would have been just instant stuff killer.
It would have taken so much longer to finish, too.
It's almost right now instant stuff killer, but...
it was supposed to be instant stuff killer.
If this was lava, I would have gone full tunnel mode and just kind of one block every few minutes sort of mode.
Okay.
Yeah, homie don't play that.
Okay, I should make Void of that next time.
Oh, Void. Yeah, just devil. Void everything. You'll like it.
It kind of looks like that from way up here. We couldn't tell what was going on. So, I mean, it is very trippy when you're playing it.
Mm-hmm.
And it wasn't, I think, until Kit fell down there that we knew that we were safe to fall. Well,
not safe.
That our stuff wouldn't be instantly destroyed if we fell.
Yeah. Did you get the emerald from here?
Yes.
We did.
We got all the emeralds. Yeah.
We did eventually get all of them.
Okay. Yeah, this one we kind of were like, oh my god, that was so obvious. How did we miss it?
Yeah.
Yeah, if it's so dark, it's obvious. We don't. Otherwise, okay, yeah, you can see it a bit, but if you look around, you can see it, but
we were under stress the first time we were down here.
Yeah, so you don't bump into it.
Right. So, and I was kind of like jumping up whenever I saw it, and I was like, oh, hey, look, emerald.
Mm.
That's where it is.
Because
we thought it was going to be very... I'm glad we didn't go all the way to the bottom when we were looking.
Yeah. I was already at the spider when Kit found it. I was working my way down, so I'm glad he found it.
You also probably didn't notice that there weren't skeletons in this area.
Thankfully.
Right.
I didn't notice, but yeah. Okay, thank you. Yeah.
Me being nice.
Yeah.
Oh, you're so nice.
Yeah, it's so nice that the next map I will just blatantly stab you in the back.
Your next one's supposed to actually be a hard one, right?
Yeah.
Creepers and ladders.
creepers.
creepers and ladders.
Yeah. Please don't. I will play it if you do.
Oh, it's not going to be next map, but there is something in store for you.
Oh, no.
It's going to be fun.
Oh, God. Ugh. Ugh.
So
let's get out of here.
Is there anything big that we missed over here?
Oh, yeah, over here. Wait. Yeah, over here, Keith. Oh, shit. So...
What? Really?
If you have this thing... There was actually Logan in one of his videos. He was walking by, and he was like, oh, yeah, this looks like something where a shortcut would come out. Like, when you come back from something. And this is my homage to speedrunners. There's basically a... The Gemlight Bog is on the opposite side. It's really close. They're almost touching. There's a layer of bedrock between them. So that if you hear slime noises, because those are really loud.
Uh-huh.
Which I learned from Myriad Caves with the honeypots. Yeah, then you would at least have a way to get here, but you wouldn't have to dig towards it.
Wow.
Well, we're getting ahead of ourselves over here, but...
Yeah,
that's a little bit. Wow, that shortcut.
Mm-hmm. And it would actually be fun to find, because just when you find like a secret passage to like the next world, then you're like, oh wait, what?
Oh, what no, is this? I'm not prepared for this.
That's yeah, and then you actually feel threatened, and it feels way more mysterious and whatever.
That's the most obvious wall. How did we not dig that wall?
I find it so funny that Largon was like, oh yeah, this is where a shortcut should come out of. And he didn't dig there. I was so sad he didn't.
He didn't? Oh, well, it's because, okay, well, let's, you know, on that note, let's get game mode zero and let's go to the place. Is this the right way to the place?
What place?
The not the intersection, the place right outside the monument. Yeah, it's this way.
What?
Right outside the monument. Oh. Back to intersection one.
Oh, and this small intersection thing.
Uh-huh. Where all the shortcuts to the various intersections meet up.
Yeah.
Okay, so, I mean, is there some sort of something in here stopping the player from digging through this?
Oh, yeah, there is. I told you about it, too.
Wait, did you... Was that in your... Wait, did you actually dig towards it?
I no. did. Without,
Without recording.
Yeah.
You saw the message? Yeah. There was like a really funny message, like, why the fuck do you always dig around my stuff?
Yeah.
What do you think you're doing? No, nothing up there.
Okay, I gotta look around, because now you got me thinking I missed everything everywhere. Hey, that's our button!
Because so many people were like, oh wait, in Goliath, or, oh yeah, that's the next shortcut is probably going to be here. Let's dig towards it. And nobody did this over here. And I was like, oh, please. Now I left something for you and you don't want it. Okay.
You know. All right. I didn't do that. I didn't do that in Goliath.
Aurora
Kit,
Valley?
When you play Goliath, don't go digging around looking for shortcuts.
Yeah, don't do that. Oh, you're going to get blown up.
Oh, no.
Can you?
Probably now, because he's, nope. like, updating it, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
right?
I don't know if... Updating maps is annoying as hell.
Oh, sweet. I love Carrot Valley.
Oh, Carrot Valley. Yay.
Good old Woo! Carrot Valley.
Yeah, I actually, try to fix those damn things. because it's basically the scoreboard is for using the item, so that counts as eating and planting it. So I'm thinking of that. If you use it like more than once a second, because the eating animation is a second or two, I think. And then if you use it more than that, then you just get no health back.
Okay.
Well, these are all words so that gives... I don't understand.
Can you make it so it gives, like, a whole lot less health?
Yeah, I'm thinking of just giving it regen. Anyways. This is the pretty area.
Yeah.
Eye candy.
Yeah. Very, very nice. It's a lot nicer at nighttime. I don't know if that's something you want to kind of force on people, like when you come through this hallway, maybe force it to be nighttime.
I have done that a lot in this map. Just when you come out of something, yeah.
It's a certain.
Gotcha. Light. I didn't know that. I didn't notice,
yeah.
But.
Yeah, Corona Chamber did that.
Oh,
like
Corona
when
Chamber
you come
is
in,
cool.
It's precisely evening, so you get this effect.
Oh,
okay.
War, we never
you
got
get this
yet.
Really red fog effect, and it's really hellish and doomish. That's a cold chest, I think.
What's that, Kit?
We never got this cold chest.
Which
like, we
chest?
Were looking at it a lot.
My creation! No!
What?
Why did you burn it?
What are you talking about? I don't know where you guys are.
Oh, over here.
Why did we burn what? Oh, we didn't do that.
Oh,
wow. What happened?
Oh, lightning struck.
Had to have been, yeah. We didn't do that. We didn't do any burning, actually.
Okay.
Oddly enough.
Oh, wow.
Nice.
Huh. I know that we missed something in the wall over here because I saw Brian get this a few episodes ago in his series.
Oh, where? Where are you?
Right here.
Where's right here?
Yeah.
I can't follow your voice.
Follow the sound of my voice, Kit.
Oh,
go up
Kit.
And
up, Kit, up. Follow the sound of burning carrots.
Oh, I can smell those from my
I don't even know where he spotted this from.
How did he spot that?
He spends a lot of time looking at the walls. I'm not saying that as a dig or anything. He legit spends a lot of time looking at the walls. So
he looks for details.
He does, and he's good at finding them. So it had probably saw it from over here.
Yeah, you were supposed to find over here, and it's like a ring of glowstone. It's now, it's actually not as obvious in your version as it is in his.
Oh, okay.
That's our excuse. Yep.
Yeah. We found the X in the water.
Oh, yeah.
Everybody I've seen has found the X.
Yeah, no, it's really obvious because of the way water and the lighting works.
Right.
Like, you can't miss this. Let's be honest.
When I saw that, I was kind of hoping the old treasure maps were making a comeback.
I wanted to have them in here, but just the areas are just too small for them. Like, you get literally the whole area, and you're like, oh, yeah, it's over here. Oh,
sure.
Yeah, here.
I suppose I understand that, yeah.
Maybe Primeval Woods.
Maybe, but that place is so dense, that would be really tough to...
Yeah, everything just looks the same from the top of a map.
Yeah. Oh. Did you like Kit's addition to your Northern Lights?
Mm-hmm. Well, I do have some problems with it.
Uh-oh.
Like, if you have the pixel art, this does not look like the pixel art of the carrots. Let's be honest.
Oh, wow, Kit. Did you...
Wow.
Like, them are fighting words.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
I don't know if you've noticed or not, but I exclusively eat carrots now. Like, in real life, that's what a carrot looks like.
I don't know. I'm holding a carrot, and it's pretty...
Oh.
Oh, boy.
So yeah, that's down probably... here, the biggest mistake of the map is actually down here.
Oh.
Like, and it's at the very beginning, and it's just the worst mistake possible I ever saw.
What? What are you talking about?
It's...
Yeah. I don't know, because I planted those around, like, in a 4x4.
Uh-huh.
Oh, extra sap.
Yeah, and I'm just waiting
what you guys were saying, yeah.
Yeah, and I'm waiting for them to grow while the vines are growing. So I don't understand why this buggy game creates a 1x1 when I have a 2x2.
Yeah, I think you just answered your own question there. Buggy
yeah,
game, man.
Buggy.
Buggy
like,
game.
Like, go...
You know, that's probably a good place to end this episode.
Oh, yeah? Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And we can pick this up again in the next one. We should probably also turn the rain on for a second.
Oh, yeah.
So, I mean, unless we don't like our frames.
Game rule.
Frames are random. For...
Let me turn fire tick off.
Could do that, too. All right, so thanks for watching, everybody. We'll be back with some more, I don't know, post-game commentary, whatever you want to call it.
Yeah.
In the next episode.
In Corona...
My Raid Trails.
Yeah, that's what it was. My bad.
Yeah.
Sorry, Rinder.
Peace.